Okay, ang lesson natin this evening is all about sequence. Actually, sa ibang book, progression ang tawag. Now, by this time, sequence muna tayo ang tawag natin sa ating aralin dahil yan ang module na ibinigay ng inyong guro. So, ito yung mga objectives na ibinigay ng inyong teacher last time sa inyong module. Una, write the terms of a sequence. So, paano ba yung pagsusulat ng bawat term ng isang sequence from the very start up to a certain number of term? Kung ano ba yung hanggang posisyon ang gusto nating maisulat, kung hanggang 10th term, 11th term, or any term na gusto nating ma-write. Second one, determine whether a sequence converges or diverges. So, sasabihin mo lang kung converge ba or diverges yung isang sequence by looking at its characteristics, yung resulta natin, at saka yung dating ng mga sequence natin. And then, write a formula for the end term of a sequence. So, ibig sabihin, magpo-formulate tayo given the following sequence. So, we'll practice to that. And then, we have to use the properties of monotonic sequence and bounded sequences. So, lahat ng yan, sasalakayin natin for the whole period. So, this is the definition of sequence. A sequence is actually a function whose domain is the set of positive integers. So, puro mga positive integers lang tayo para sa ating domain. Although a sequence is a function, it is common to represent sequences by subscript notation rather than by the standard function notation. For instance, in the sequence, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so on and so forth. And this given example of a sequence that your prof gave you actually is an example of arithmetic sequence. So iba-ibang klase yung sequence eh. Kaya lang dito hindi nyo pa inaaral. Ang focus ninyo is more on converges and diverges and then monotonic at saka bounded. So, yun muna ang inyong inaaral. Pero meron tayong tinatawag na arithmetic sequence. Just like, for example, this given example in our illustration is an example of arithmetic sequence. Why is it an arithmetic sequence? Because kung titingnan natin yung pagkasunod-sunod ng mga sequence natin, meron silang common difference. Just like, for example, yung 2 and 1, may difference na 1. And then 3 and 2, may difference na 1. Ang 4 and 3, ganun din. So, lahat ng magkakasunod na term, may common difference. And their common difference is 1. And this given example is actually in sequence. Ang ibig sabihin ng A sub 1, A sub 2, na may subscript na 1, 2, 3, lahat ng A, mga term yan. So, A sub 1 means we are pertaining to the first term. A sub 2, ibig sabihin the second term is 2. Our third term is 3. Yan ang ibig sabihin ng A sub 3. And then A sub 4, ang fourth term natin is 4. And then A sub n, ang n term natin is n. So it is a function because kapag nag-substitute ka ng particular number, positive integer, meron siyang sariling data na maanap natin. Halimbawa, 1 is mapped onto A sub 1. 2 is mapped onto A sub 2, and so on. So yung A sub 1, gagamitin natin yung 1 pag sa pag-aanap ng value ng A sub 1, and so on. The numbers A sub 1, A sub 2, A sub 3, hanggang A sub n are the terms of the sequence. The number A sub n is the n-term of the sequence, and the entire sequence is denoted by a sub n. So nagbabago lang yung n. Kung pang-apat na term ang a sub n natin is a sub 4. Kung panglimang term ang a sub n natin is a sub 5. So ganun lang kasimple ang ibig sabihin ng sequence. Yun nga lang, iba't ibang klase ang sequence na meron tayo. Hindi lang naman arithmetic sequence, meron pa tayong dinatawag na geometric sequence. So example number one, ito yung mga halimbawa na ibinigay ng yung teacher. Actually, writing the terms of a sequence yan eh. So, ibig sabihin, yung pagkasunod-sunod ng mga term, yung mga entry from first term, second, third, fourth, and so on and so forth, kailangan na may list down natin, may lista natin gamit yung formula na ibinigay ng inyong guro. For example, sa number one, ang ibinigay is a sub n equals to 3 plus the exponent n na naka-raise ang negative 1 are the following na ibinigay dito sa ating figure, sa ating given sa number 1. So you don't have to worry, ipapractice natin yan. Subukan natin gawin yung buong yan, yung given na yan. So tingnan natin, no? Negative 1. When a negative number is raised by an odd exponent, tandaan mga anak, kapag ang exponent is odd number, and then negative yung number na naka-raise sa odd exponent, automatic negative yan. Result natin. Negative 1 raised to 1 is negative 1. But positive times negative is negative, then 3 minus 1 is 2. Ito yung computation natin dito sa una. Ito yung 2. And then, yung negative 1 is a negative number, but since yung exponent niya is even, automatic positive ang makukuha natin. So, negative 1 square is positive 1, and then 3 plus 1 is 4. So, madali lang siya dito. Negative 1, kapag naka-raise sa odd number, 3 is an odd number, so negative ang value. So, 3 minus 1 is 2. And then negative is naka-raise na naman sa even number, makukuha natin is positive. That is why 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. And actually, same thing with the second example that your teacher gave you. Kung papasinin natin, ito yung mga substitution process sa baba. Yan. Ito sila. And to make it very clear, gagawin ko sila on the spot. Isosolve natin sila. Yan na solve natin para klaro-klaro gamit ang Microsoft Word. Para lang mas maintindihan ninyo yung writing the terms of a sequence. And then I will add some more examples para mas maintindihan ninyo yung writing the terms of sequence. And actually, your prof already gave you, for example, this include letter C and letter D as written from your module. Sa letter C, the terms of the sequence C sub n is equal to the n square all over 2 raised to n minus 1. At nandiyan yung kanyang mga calculation and then results sa baba, including letter D. And para lang mas maging klaro, okay, skip ko lang siya. Discard ko muna. Okay, let's proceed here. Yan. Para lang malinaw. So, ito yung formula natin na ibinigay ng inyong guro sa ating example letter A. So, para lang mas detalyado at saka organize yung solution ninyo, ito lang na makadali yan. If n is equal to 1, ganito lang yan mga anak para mas malinaw yung computation ninyo. If n is equal to 1. You do it this way para impressive yung computation. Alam na ninyo eh, kaya lang, lagyan naman ng datin yung computation ninyo para mas ma-impress yung teacher ninyo. So a sub 1, ibig sabihin, lagyan natin is 1, so I'll change that to 1, and then yung exponent natin dito is 1. Then yung calculation natin, definitely this will be 2. And then the second one, we have, again, this will be a sub 2. yung n natin, siyempre yung exponent natin isusunod naman. But since the exponent is an even number, definitely the result will be equal to 1. That is why 3 plus positive 1. And this will be equal to 4. Yan. And then for the next one, we have a sub 3. We're going to calculate it. So kalsang ko yun. Magiging a sub 3. And even the exponent here, magiging 3. Equal 3. Negative raised to an odd number is always negative. But 1 cubed is also 1. So the result is 2. So kung analyze natin yung sequence, mamaya, no, continue pa natin yan. Meron talagang mga sequence na yung mga sagot is paulit-ulit lang. Okay, look at it. So I'll change this to 4. Yan. And then even here, change ko ng 4 yan. Equal 3. But negative 1 or the negative number is raised to an even number. That's why the result will be positive. But 1 raised to the 4th power is simply equal to 1. That's why ang sagot natin is 4. So, if you will try to assess the given, 2, 4, 2, 4, definitely ang panglimang term is 2. Because we can already see a pattern. So, 2, 4, 2, 4, 2, 4, lahat yan. So, let us see now. Kung ano yung a sub 5, try natin. Para masigurado tayo. Now, if this is 5, or a sub 5, ang exponent natin dito will be 5. And then equal. So ilalagay ko 3 minus 1. This will be equal to 2. Now para mabilis ang calculation, look at it mga anak. No? Since I have my calculator here, okay, mode, and then I will try to use table. Table tayo, yung f of x. Okay? So, tatype ko yung formula. 3 plus, and then I'll type, diba negative 1 ito? Yan. I'll try this. I'll try negative 1. And then, naka-exponent yan. Yung negative 1. And then, I'll try instead of n, tatype ko is alpha x. Alpha x siya. Yan. And then I'll press the equal sign, the equal symbol. And then saan bang range daw magsisimula? 1. So I'll type 1. And then equal. Saan mag-end? Kung gusto nyo hanggang 5, hanggang 6 pwede. So yun dito hanggang 5 lang tayo. Dinagdagan ko kasi ng isa. So I'll type 5. So ibig sabihin, yung mga terms from a sub 1 hanggang a sub 5, ibibigay ng calc Q and then one click lang. And sila, oh, kung pasinin natin, 2, 4, 2. Move yung cursor down. At yung fourth term natin, 4 din sa right column. And then yung last term natin is 2. Guess ba ninyo mga anak?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so klaro, mabilis sa calc, lahat ng mga hanapin natin, i-table lang natin, one click lang yung mga solutions. And even na i-replay man natin yan, okay, no? Equal. Okay, i-replay ko. Ayaw ma-replay. Anyway, pwede namang ganito eh. Ayaw mabalik eh. Okay, mode 5 ko uli. Yan, tingnan nyo ah. Mode 5. Mode, on ko muna. Mode, yan. Okay. 3 plus negative 1. And then, halimbawa gusto ko hanggang 10 term. I'll type 10. So, one click lang sila lahat. Makikita mo, 1, I'll type 1 hanggang sa 10 term, then 10. Teka lang, tama ba yung tinype ko kanina? Parang may error sa na type ko eh, hindi ko na x. Okay, ulitin ko. Okay, f of x, we have 3 plus, eto, negative 1, exponent, alpha x, yan. And then, I'll press the equal symbol. I'll type 1, ibig sabihin, first term hanggang 10 term tayo. Ita-type ko ang 10. Now, equal. You will see then, 2, 4, 2 hanggang third term. Fourth term is 4, fifth term is 2, sixth term is 4, seventh term is 2, eighth term is 4, ninth term is 2, and then 10th term is 4. So, one click lang sila lahat. Huwag ba natin mga anak? Hello? Ika-concept ko na para mapabilis. Now, let us see the second problem that your teacher gave you. So, ito yung formula natin. B sub n is equals to n over 1 minus 2n. Yung B sub n, assume na lang natin na f of x yan. And then, lahat ng x na nakikita natin sa equation, lahat ng n magiging x. So, we do this. So, para one time lang yung pag-solve natin gamit ang calculator, ma-enjoy naman ninyo yung technology. And even with the Canon na calculator, pwede nyo gawin yan. Actually, may kilala akong author ng mga books, si Romeo Tolentino na napakagaling talaga. Natuturo yan sa National University sa pagkakalampi. Kasamaan ko yan sa MTAP. So, pwede ninyong bilhin yung libro niya na about Canon para matuto kayo sa mga calculator techniques. Yun ang bagong uso ngayon eh. Maliban sa Casio, meron din tayong Canon. So maganda yung Canon. Okay, try natin. Tignan natin kung negative 1, negative 2 third, negative 3 fifth, and negative 4 7 makukuha sa calculator ng mabilisan. So again, mode 7. So always use mode table, mode 7. So, yung B sub n natin ito, yun din ang f of x. So, yung n over 1 minus 2n, itatype natin sila ng ganito. Since walang n, we'll make use of alpha x. So, x over 1 minus 2, and then I'll type alpha x. Yan. And then equal, siyempre, start natin sa first term, definitely. 1. Yung n natin is 1. And then ends with, dito hanggang 4 term lang ang binigay. So subukan natin hanggang 6 term. And let us see kung tumama lahat ng mga sagot dito na nakasequence from negative 1, negative 2, 3, negative 3, 5, negative 4, 7. You may write all the terms instantly using calculator. And since alam naman ninyo ng manumano yan eh, kahit magmanumano tayo para na makukuha natin. Okay, equal. Yan. Nakadesimal sila. Yun nga lang, yun ang kaibaan, no? Nakadesimal. Anyway, madali lang naman eh. Dito, naka-fraction. Pwede naman ninyong i-double check. Tignan nyo, na-type ko sila. So, yung first term natin, negative 1. Sa calculator, ang lumitaw, negative 0.666. Okay, negative 0.666 ang tayo ito. Or, yan, hanggang dyan na lang. Pangit yung numero eh, yan. And then, next, negative 0.6. Negative 0.6. And the next one, kung ibababa pa natin yung cursor, yung fourth, fifth, and the sixth term, negative 0.571. I'll type them, negative 0.571, and then followed by negative 0.555, negative 0.555, and yung panglimang term, and then yung last term, click natin pababa, negative 0.545, negative 0.545. Madali lang naman yan, mga anak na tinay nyo. Look at the way I'm going to do it. Para lang mas maiintindihan ninyo. Okay, natin ninyo. Mode 1 ko muna uli. Iba't yun yung mga data na nakuha natin. Take a look at negative 2/3. I-fraction lang natin ito. Look at it. Negative 2/3. Teka lang. Delete ko muna. 2 over 3. Tapos kini equal. SD ko siya. Ayan siya. Ito yung pangalawa. And then yung pangatlo, negative 3 pip. Okay, replay ko lang siya. Palitan ko lang yung nasa taas. 3. And then denominator will be equal to 5. And teka, hindi siya na baba. 5 tayo. Then alpha is equal. You will see that it is 0.6. Negative 0.6. And then dito, negative 4 over 7. Tinanong nga natin kung negative 0.571. Okay, ito. Hindi ko na ilagay yung negative. Alam naman natin na negative eh. 4 over 7 na lang. And that's it. 4 over 7. Diba? ST ko siya, negative 0.571. Can you follow, mga anak? Nakukuha ba ninyo?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so as simple as that, hindi naman siya ganun kahirap. Kung nag-multiple choice na calculator ka, eh, double check mo lang yung mga fraction kung tapat ba sa bawat decimal na meron tayo. Anyway, dito, naka-round off yan. Okay, so let us proceed to the next one. So this is n squared over 2 to the n minus 1. O, yan lang itatype natin. So dito, nag-fraction na naman sila. Fraction na naman. Anyway, madali lang naman eh. Tinay ito, 66 yan, 2 decimal, di ba? Kung nag-round off ka, 67 siya. Alam mo, continuous na 66 yan. If I'll be using my calculator and doing it this way, dalawang decimal, so ibig sabihin, kailangan ko ng dalawang zero. So 67 over 100 yan. Kasi yung equal, ayan, 0.67. This is 0.571, di ba? So 3 decimal point yan. Kaya lang, mahirap siyang uliin dito kasi continuous siya. Yun lang ang hirap doon. Pero kung magmamano-mano ka, then fraction yung nakuha natin, makukuha naman ninyo lahat yung mga yan. Madali lang naman. Okay, we do it here. Try natin. Mano-mano naman. Okay, since yun natin yung formula natin, copy ko siya. Okay, with the first example, we try if n is equal to 1. Now, if n is equal to 1, so ganyan ang kadali. Mabak. Lakihan ko siya. Bakit 1 over 1 yun? Tignan natin, no? 1. Then, syempre, ito is magiging 1 din. And then, C sub 1 time. Yan. Babago lang yun. Okay. So sa taas, 1 square, alam naman natin na 1 equal. So we do it by fraction. So 1 square is 1. 2 raised to 1 is 2. Then minus 1 is still 1. That's why the obtained answer is 1. So ganun lang siya. Pangalawa, copy-paste ko lang ito. Ano lang naman yung mababago dyan eh, yung mga numbers lang. So this will be C sub 2. And then yung nga lang yung sa taas is magiging 2 square. And then ito, magiging 2 to the n, di ba? So 2 square din yan. So 2 square is equal to 4 sa denominator. And then with the denominator, magiging 4 minus 1 yan dahil lang 2 square is 4. And then 4 minus 1. So delete ko muna to. Fraction uli natin. So we will be having a result of 4 over 3. Konting algebra lang. So I don't see that it is difficult. Importante lang, maintindihan ninyo yung mga terminologies. Kung kailan nga ba nagiging divergence, or converges, kailan ba nagiging monotonic yung isang sequence. So, ayun, 1, 4 over 3. Now, if we're going to do it with a calculator, applicable, yan. Yung nga lang, magkakaroon tayo ng decimal. So, I think this is 1 and 1 third, or 1.33 yan, yung second term. So, let us see. Mode table ko uli, 7. And I'll be typing n squared over 2 to the n minus 1. But ganito yung pagka-type. Alpha x and then square over 2 exponent alpha x minus 1. Dahil wala namang n eh. Yeah. And then I'll press equal. Sa given example is hanggang apat na term lang. So we do that hanggang pang-apat lang. 1. And then we'll end at 4. Then I'll press equal. Equal again. Ayan. 1.333, 1.2857. Hanggang sa pang-apat na term. Makikita natin lahat yan. 0.6666. Ito, tinan natin, no? So this is 16 over 15. So let us see kung tama tayo. Kung ayong ano natin. So nakuha ko. Ay po sila. 1. Para kung may mali, makorek natin. Ayun, 1. And then followed by the next number. Para makaroon tayo ng comparison. 1.3333. Then followed by the next number. Imposibleng magkamali yan. Calculator yan, mga anak, no? 1.2857. And then 16 over 15. And natin ay katapat niya. Pang-apat. 1.0. Yan. Ayun yung mga nakuha nating number. So let us see. Try natin 16 over 15. So let's try that. 16. I-on ko muna. And then mode 1. Mode 1. Yan. Computation mode ko muna. Okay. 16 over 15. Let us see. 16 divided by 15. ST ko siya. Ayan siya. Nako. Kamukhang kamukha. Klaro ba? Klaro? Klaro?
Yes po. Yes, sir.
Okay, so, yung number 4 na ibinigay ng teacher ninyo, actually, nung pinansin ko siya, tinay niya yung mga numbers, 25, yung una daw, 25, yung first term. Yung pangalawang term daw is 20. Yung pangatlo is 15. Yung pangapat is 10. Ang ginawa kasi, ganito yung nangyari dyan, kwento ko lang. 25 daw yung first term. Okay, linawin ko, no? Para lang mas maintindihan ninyo yung example. I-elaborate ko siya sa inyo. Ang isang buwan daw, 25 ang value. Yan. And that's it. And then, yung second term ng teacher ninyo na kanyang ibinigay sa kanyang calculation, okay, so a sub 2, so a sub 2 natin is equal to 20 na naanap niya, 25 minus 5 equals 20. So yung a sub 3, ito nangyari dyan eh. A sub 3, any receipt, no? Is equal to, diba yung previous is 20, so continuous yan, na minus uli sa lang 5. That is why ang na-obtain is 15. And then pagdating sa pang-apat, ganun din ang kanyang ginawa. A sub 4, para lang mas maintindihan ninyo, lulutuin natin. So, 15 yung previous, di ba? So, sa previous na a sub 3, which is 15, nag-minus uli siya ng 5. That is why na-obtain ang sagot na 10. So, hanggang 4 lang pala binigay niya, 25, 20, 15, and 10. So, yun yung pagkakasunod ng mga number, 25, 20, 15, and then 10, and then etc. Now, kung susundan pa natin yan, tignan nyo ha, Dagdagan ko, gawin ko ng A sub 5. A sub 5. Para lang mas klaro. Yan. So, 10 yung previous. So, minus uli ako ng 5. So, kasunod niya is 5. So, dito, kung dadagdagan ko yan, meron pang isang 5. Then, that. Ibig sabihin, continuous. Nag-guess nyo? Nag-guess yung mga anak?
Yes, po.
Okay. So, lalakihan ko lang. Enter ko to para lang mas maintindihan ninyo yung example ni sir. Para well elaborated. Okay. Actually, yung binigay na example ni sir ninyo, para ma-enlist lang natin. Halimbawa yan, anak, ng arithmetic sequence na binabanggit ko kanina. And arithmetic sequence is an example of a sequence na nanggaling niya sa formula na yan. A sub n is actually the formula for the nth term. A sub 1 plus n minus 1 minus d. At kapag alam mo ang simula ng sequence, yung first term natin dito is 25. Eh. Tama? In this given sequence, the first term natin is 25. So look at it. I will write the formula. Ang first term natin is 25. Ganito yan. Sulat ko siya. And so happened in our given sequence, the common difference. Ang common difference, 20 minus 25, 15 minus 20, 10 minus 15. Ang common difference is 5. Look at it. I'll type the common difference and I'll call it as letter D. D is the common difference. So mauna tayo sa last. 5 minus 10. Ito yun mga anak. 5 minus 10. And then is also equal to 10 minus 15. And is also equal to 15 minus 20. And of course, 20 minus 25. Common difference of negative 5. So yun yung binabanggit kong common difference. Yan. And then n. Limbawa, 5 terms. Depende kasi kung ano yung inaalam mo, kung A sub 1 ba, kung A sub 2, kung A sub 3, or A sub 4. Now look at it. Kung ang n natin is equal to 1, let us apply this formula. Actually, kahit na pang ilang term, haanap ninyo eh. Ito yan, no? Yung kagandahan ng arithmetic sequence. Dinagdag ko lang sa discussion ni sir. Na yung bang tipong hindi mo maanap ang kahit na hindi mo anapan ng third term, maanap mo ang 6, ang 7, ang 10th term. So do it this way. Tingnan nyo ha. So kung i-adapt ko yan, isa buwan tayo. Yan. Maganda sa formula na yan eh. Dinagdagan ko lang para mas maging enriched. So isa buwan natin, halimbawa, inaanap ninyo, fifth term. Gusto nating maanap, 5 talaga yan. No? Ang isang buwan natin is 25. Dahil 5 term, ang yan natin will be 5. 5 minus 1. Ang common difference na nakalculate natin kanina is negative 5. Let us see kung maanap natin ang 5 term na negative 5. So yung 5 term, yun pala 5. Ito yung inaanap natin, 5. Equal 25. Then plus 5 minus 1 is 4. And their common difference is negative 5. Let us see kung tatama tayo. 25. Ano ba yun? 5 minus 1. Hindi ko na-type 4 ito. Yan, di ba? 5 minus 1 is 4. That's why 4. Then 4 times negative 5 is negative 20. So we can have a result of 5. Nakuha niya? Ayun siya, oh, yung fifth term, A sub 5. And then let us try with the A sub 4. What if, ito, no? Dito ang ginawa natin, n sub 1 is 5 pala siya. Yan. So a sub 5. Now what if kung ang n naman natin is 3. Let's try if n is 3 is equal to 3. Tingnan natin. If n is equal to 3, dinagdagan ko lang yung ginawa ni teacher sa example niya. Now eto, adapuli yung formula. Kahit pa nga ang pang-isang daang term, makukuha ninyo eh, nang hindi na inaalam yung previous niya. Dito naanap natin ang 5 nang hindi na kailangang alamin ang 4. Kasi ang ginawa niya, nag-minus siya ng patuloy-tuloy na 5. Previously, mawa, 25 minus 5 is 20. 20 minus 5 is 15. 15 minus 5 is 10. 5 minus 5 is 0. Tingnan nyo ha, ang kasunod dito, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, so 0 yon. So tingnan natin kung 6, balit lang ko, gawin kong 6. So A sub 6 yan. So ang A sub 1 natin, 25 pa rin. Minus, dahil pangalim na term, this will be 6. And then ang common difference is negative 5. Look at it. Negative 5. So let us see kung 0 mahanap natin. 25 plus 6 minus 1 is 5 times negative 5. So we have it as 25 minus 25 because 5 times negative 5 is negative 25. So the result is 0. Kumbaga, dinagdagan ko lang yung ibinigay na alimbawa na inyong guro. Dadagdagan ko yan. 0. Then, dot. Kung dadagdagan ko isa taas, dito, no? Look at it. Pwede kong sabihin at 15 minus 5 is 10. 10 minus 5 is 5. 5 minus 5 is 0. Actually, kinumpleto ko siya. Nakukuha ba ninyo? Kaso ba manganap?
Yes po.
Hello?
Yes
po. Francis?
Yes po.
Are you still with me?
Yes sir.
Hello mga anak.
Hello po.
Hello?
We're still here.
Hello sir. Po.
Sir?
Kung baga dadagdagan ko ito, dinig pa ba ninyo ako?
Yes po sir.
Hello? So this will be 5 minus 5 and here is 0. So yun yung nasa slide natin. Hello, are you still with me? Dinig pa ba ninyo ako?
Yes sir. Yes po.
Dinig pa ba niyo ako mga anak? Hello?
Hello po.
Okay, so continue natin. Kayo mga limbawa,